find patients waiting for days and left in pain in Manchester unit. Snowden running out of asylum options. Which sort of takes us to your point. You think that Mr. Snowden should be... now, this is the fellow who leaked the news that the Americans were bugging Europeans and so forth. You think he should be offered citizenship here?
Yeah, for many reasons. I mean, first of all, he's done all European citizens a great public service by ringing the alarm bells about the fact that the United States intelligence services were bugging EU offices.
Yeah, but apparently they weren't bugging us.
Well, we're part of the European Union. And yeah, we're part
do you not feel slightly offended that we weren't?
Well, I'm sure they're probably gathering lots of information on us anyway. I'm sure they have. They control Shannon Airport, let's not forget. So they've quite a foothold here. But there is a serious issue. I mean, they justify all this these intelligence services on the basis of the so-called war on terror. They certainly can't use that justification.
And would you bring him in ahead of Julian Assange, who's sitting in a...
I think anybody who blows the whistle on serious matters of public
and
interest...
And you would bring in Julian Assange as well?
I would, yeah. I mean, although Julian Assange has real questions to answer over allegations made against him in Sweden.
Well, if he did come here, would you send him back to Sweden, he's wanted on very soon?
I think he has to face serious accusations, but I wouldn't send him to a country where he would just be rendered.
Well, Sweden is a very safe country, I think. Much less likely to extradite you to the United States than England, I think.
Well, it's not certain that if he went back to Sweden, he wouldn't be rendered back or extradited
back. Do the women Sweden, then, would they not be entitled to some justice?
I just said they should be. Should be. And he should have to face some due process in that regard. But he shouldn't.
But not in Sweden?
Not in the United States. And they're safe.
No, but he was not going to the United States, he was going to Sweden.
Yeah, but he would need safeguards that he wouldn't be extradited back to the United States. And that was his concern. And that would be my concern. But if I can make the more general point about whistleblowing and the Irish government. The Irish government in the programme for government committed to support whistleblowing and indeed promised, and they haven't done it yet, to bring legislation forward supporting and protecting whistleblowers. Now, there couldn't be a clearer example of where they need to sort of pin their colours to the mast in that regard. Here is somebody who's done us public service, has had the courage and a great personal risk, blown the whistle. And I think if our government is serious about wanting to protect whistleblowers and encourage them, they should
offer
him asylum.
When he joined the CIA, I wonder if it not have occurred to him at some stage he might have to do a bit of spying?
Maybe he genuinely believed he was acting for national security and then discovered that actually he wasn't, and that what the CIA were engaged in, or the National Security Agency were engaged in, was spying on what were supposedly friendly allied countries for economic reasons, because that can be the only explanation for why they would bug EU Commission offices. And, you know, I mean, when we look at what the Anglo tapes have done to give us inside information about what goes on in the banks, don't we want to encourage whistleblowing of that kind? Wouldn't it be great if we had whistleblowers in the bank?
Whistleblowing now, when you think.
No, but I'm saying, wouldn't it be great if we had.
And the guards had those tapes for a long time.
Sam, wouldn't it be good if we had an Edward Snowden in the banks, in the Department of Finance, in some of these golden circles, to blow the whistle on what was really going on and give the information to us, to the public, that we really want? So if the government are serious about open, transparent government, encouraging whistleblowers, why not send a signal by inviting Edward Snowden
here? Billy was once a member of the Defence Forces. I don't know if you served in intelligence.